The coordinate of an unknown point relative to a known coordinate can be determined by using total station as long as direct line of sight can be established between two points. Hi friends, welcome back to Learn and Explore. So today in this video, I will going to discuss about how total station really works. What is the calculation behind the total stations giving us nodding, easting and elevation value of an unknown point with respect to a coordinate position. Okay, so before going to start my video, if you are new to our channel, please do subscribe our channel, and if you think that this video will help you, please do like, comment and share with others so that others can get help from this video. And we have already provided a video on how you can use total station in field practically, and you can check this out from our channel's playlist. So friends, when we placed a total station on a point of known coordinate, which can be assumed by us, here I am assuming the coordinate of this point is 1000 and elevation is 100. Okay, then we have to first do leveling, centering and orientation. After that, we can do the further work, or total station can do the further work. Okay, so as soon as our leveling, centering and orientation is done, orientation means we'll locate the nodding position to the total station. Okay, when orientation is done, then the total station bisects the target, that is our prism, bisects the target center. Okay, and total station calculates the nodding, easting and elevation value of this unknown coordinate. And in this video, we will know how total station calculates the nodding, easting and elevation values of this unknown point with respect to these known coordinates. Okay, so total station, when we bisect the target, total station send a ray to the target center and then it reflects back. So total station calculate the incline distance by the help of time difference and speed of light of the same frequency is generated from the ETS and it reflects back to the target towards the ETS. Okay, in this process, that means the ray is going to the target and again reflects back to the total station receiver. The total station calculate this incline length, that is this incline distance ID, which is equal to, we all know that distance is equal to time into speed. So this ID is calculated as the time required to cut or intersect the or bisects the target and reflects back. So this is our T1 and the reflects back time is T2. So our time difference is T2 minus T1. Okay, and if we multiply by the speed of the ray or light, we can get this incline distance, but this distance is twice the actual distance is, because the ray bisects and again reflects back to the total station, so it calculates the twice distance. So if we want to find the incline distance only, we have to calculate such as T1 minus T2 into speed of light by 2. In this manner, we get the incline distance. Okay, so a vertical angle is formed here, that is alpha degree, which is calculated by total station according to the tilting is done in the process of bisection, right? So this is our alpha angle, or this is our vertical angle. And now we have to find out the horizontal distance HD, right? So if we find out this horizontal distance with the help of this vertical angle and the incline distance, we can easily calculate, or total station can easily calculate the northing, easting and elevation values. So first we have to find out the horizontal distance. So here you can see a triangle is formed. I'm naming here as A, B and C. So if we want to find out the HD, and our according to with respect to alpha angle, we have to just do it. So cos alpha is equal to this horizontal distance by this ID, right? So this base by hypotenuse, okay? So our base is HD by hypotenuse as our cos alpha is. So HD is equal to cos alpha into IT, right? So HD is equal to ID cos alpha, okay? So in this manner we get the horizontal distance with respect to with the help of incline distance and vertical angle. Now here I'm drawing another section. Here you can see here in this point our total station held in, it is nothing but a plan view of total station position. So here our coordinate value is 1000 1000, that means northing is 1000 and easting is also 1000 and our elevation is 100, right? So if we find this latitude and this departure value and we add this with the coordinate of this point, this is A, B, C and D, okay? If we find out this AB and this BC, we can get the coordinate of this position. On this topic we have already made a video, you can check this from our channel playlist, okay? How this latitude and departure comes from, okay? So we all know that latitude is equal to L cos theta and departure is equal to L sin theta, right? So this angle, this magnetic bearing is theta degree, which is from north towards survey line, north towards the survey line, okay? So this is our survey line. When we place the total station and bisects the target like this and we view it from the top, we can see this inclined line is merged with the horizontal line. So here this line is this line, this HD, right? So if we find out this value and this value, that means this length and this length, and we just simply add with this the coordinate of this point, we can easily find out the northing and easting value of this point. And in this way the total station calculate the northing and easting value of unknown point with respect to a known points. So now we have to find out the latitude of this triangle, right? So latitude is equal to L cos theta, we all know. So latitude by, that means AB by AC, right? That means AC, latitude is AB by AC, that is HD, okay, is equal to cos theta. So latitude is equal to HD cos theta, okay? So in this way, perpendicular by hypotenuse, right? So dip, that is BC by hypotenuse, is equal to HD by AC, is equal to sine theta. So our dip is equal to HD sine theta, right? So when we find out this latitude and departure value, and if we add it with the northing easting value of this position, we can easily find out the northing easting value of this position, because if we add the 1000 with this value and 1000, with this value we can find out the northeasting value of this point. So our northing value, northing position of point C is equal to how much? 1000 plus HD cos theta, and easting position of point C is equal to 1000 plus HD sin theta, right? So in this way, total session calculate the northing and easting value of this point, this unknown point. Now we have to find out the elevation of this point, because total station provide us the northing, easting and elevation value of an unknown point. So we are calculated from this the northing and easting value. Now we have to go for our elevation value, right? So we have, if we want to find out the elevation of this point, first we have to know the elevation of this point C. Okay, so if we calculate or if we subtract the this target height from the elevation of this point, we can get the elevation of this point. Okay, so the total station, so this is our instrument height or height of instrument of total station. I'm just naming it as H1. Okay, and this is our target height. You can see this is our target height, which is from ground surface to the target center. This is H2. Okay, this is H2, and this distance is this distance, which is from this horizontal plane to the top of the target, is H3. Is H3. Okay, this is H3. That means H1 is instrument height or height of instrument, H2 is the target height, and H3 is this horizontal to the center of the target height. Okay, so here you can see again a triangle is formed here, which is A, B and C, and we have the vertical angle alpha, right? So we have to calculate this height with the help of this inclined distance and this alpha angle, right? So here we know the sine alpha. Sine alpha is equal to BC by AC. Okay, so here sine alpha is equal to BC means H3 and AC means ID, this inclined length. Okay, so H3 is equal to ID sine alpha degree. So in this way we have to in this way the total station calculate this height, right? This height is H3. Okay, ACP. So this is our H3, and now we find out the value of H3. We know the value of H1, and we know the height of target height, which we already provided to the total station. Okay, now we have to find out the RL of point C. So if you want to find out RL of point C is equal to how much? 100, which is the height of, which is the RL of our benchmark where we place the total station. Okay, height of instrument, that is H1. Okay, that means we find the RL of this point B, and now we have to add this height, right? This H3. If we add this all, we can get the RL of point C, right? So this is our RL of point C. Now we have to find out the RL of this point, this ground point. Okay, this ground point. Now if we want to find out the RL of ground point, we have to just simply subtract the target height from the RL of point C, right? From this point, we have to subtract this height and we can get the RL of this point. RL of ground point is 100 plus H1 plus H3 minus H2. In this way, the total station get the RL of this point. So, hope you understand how the total station calculates the northing, easting and elevation value of an unknown point with respect to a known coordinate point. Okay, so now I'm summarizing the total process which is done by me. First, you have to centering and leveling the total station on felt, okay, and you have to assume, or if you have the coordinate value provided, okay, you have to take this in account, and after centering and leveling, you have to orient the total station. After orientation, you have to bisect the target. Okay, when you bisect the targets, the total station array is transmit from total station and hit to the target center and reflect back to the total station. In this way, total station calculate the double incline distance by the help of speed of light and time interval taken by the ray. Okay, after that, when you calculate the incline distance and you have vertical angle which is between the horizontal distance and incline distance, okay, with the help of this incline distance and this vertical angle, you can calculate easily the horizontal distance, right? In this manner you can calculate the horizontal distance. After calculating the horizontal distance, total station is calculate latitude and departure values of that unknown point and simply add this with the coordinate of known point. Okay, after adding, total station calculate the northing and easting position of that unknown point. When the total station calculate the northing and easting position of an unknown point, it moves to calculate further the elevation value of that unknown point. Okay, and this elevation value is calculated with the help of this incline distance and this vertical angle, right? So when we level the total station already calculate the tilting is done at the time of bisecting the target. Okay, so here you can see the total station. We have already provided the height of instrument, target height to the total station, and there is a distance between the incline height and the horizontal distance. Okay, and total station just find out the RL of point C. Okay, after that, it's just simply subtract the target height from the RL of point C and total station get the elevation value of the ground point. And in this manner, total station calculate the northing, easting and elevation value of an unknown point with respect to a known coordinate position. Okay, hope you understand how I'm doing this whole process, and if you have any question arise in your mind, please feel free to ask and we will try to explain you all. And we have already provided a video how this L cos theta and L sin theta comes from. You can watch it from our video. And we have also provided a video on how total station practically used in film. So you can also check it from our channel playlist. And please let us know by commenting us how this video will help you and how this video work is. So thank you. Thanks for watching. Thank you.